You join us in Portimao as we prepare for what will undoubtedly be a magnificent day of racing. It's time, of course, for the Portuguese Grand Prix. A lap of Portimao is 2.9 miles long, and it's made up of 15 turns, 9 right-handers and 6 left-handers. It's been described as a roller coaster with a lot of elevation changes. There's more than one blind summit, and the conditions today aren't going to make visibility any better. So drivers are going to have to be on the ball if we're to avoid a safety car here today. It's not going to be plain sailing for our drivers today, although with the sky falling as it is, perhaps sailing isn't too far from the truth. Anthony Davidson, could be a wet one today. Great to have you with us. What are your thoughts?
It is a touch damp, isn't it? Well, as a driver, there are three big things to worry about when racing in these kind of conditions. Standing water, tyre temperature and visibility. Judging distance to the cars around you is really tricky when you're driving through the vast amounts of spray that these wet weather Pirelli tyres kick up.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. With the race minutes away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and Valtteri Bottas will line up alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Perez, Norris, Charles Leclerc and Ricciardo, Gasly, Sainz, Fernando Alonso and Esteban Ocon, Stroll, Tsunoda, Sebastian Vettel and Raikkonen, Giovinazzi, Russell, Nicholas Latifi and Mick Schumacher, Mazepin and Max Verstappen completes the grid. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today?
Is good, but we need to learn the gears, so go into each one when you can. We're going to need some work on the brakes, so put some energy into them and warm the tyres as well, please. Doing well out there, keep it up. We're looking at about 10 more minutes of rain. 10 minutes. Some information on Schumacher. They're retiring from the race. The weather's certainly eased off for the time being, but we've still got a lot of standing water out there. We're happy for you to stay out on the inters for now. We're looking at another 5, maybe 10 minutes of this rain. Fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. I think we're still on the right tyres for the time being. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. DRS has been enabled. DRS is now enabled. There's 4 laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. Work. Well done. We're really happy with the podium here.
It's a performance that our Portuguese Grand Prix winners can be justifiably proud of, and I'm sure there'll be celebrations tonight. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
Well, I think it was clear what the main contributing factor out on the track was today: speed. I know it sounds like an obvious thing to say, Crofty, but fast cars win races, and we saw that today with our winner.
And I can see the drivers starting to approach the podium for the victory celebrations. A real team victory today. Everybody played their part. Congratulations then to Mercedes, your race winners today. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. It wasn't the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Often my go-to would be a driver who's managed to pull off an especially impressive feat during the race. However, in this instance, I was more impressed by Max Verstappen's solid, clean driving throughout the event.
Let's move on to the constructors. Mercedes moved to the top of the table. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend from them as they fight their way towards the top. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.